I'm very excited to be a lunchtime speaker, because when we eat together is when we plot and scheme the true revolution, is it not?
Woo!
Yes. And when we take care of each other, which is the theme of what I want to say to you this afternoon. I'm totally blown away by how many people are at this meeting. How many organizations get a couple hundred people to an organizing meeting? Phenomenal. I feel that there's a feeling these days that people are ready to get to work. We have so many challenges that we're facing. We have a scary political landscape, and people are really energized and ready to get to work. And so I'm really happy to be in a big room full of a lot of people who are feeling that way too. Are you ready to get to work? Yes. Enjoy a minute of lunch first. We can take care of ourselves before we start running to the barricades. So I am a longtime super fan of Fight for 15 and Fairness. It's one of the pivotal campaigns of our time. And I'm really just here to bring kind of extended greetings from the Leap and from the small organization of people who are working to support large numbers of people all over the place who are organizing either on Leap Manifesto projects or just inspired by that same spirit of connecting the dots among the many crises we face and advancing truly game-changing, transformative solutions that actually meet the scale of the crises that we face. So I think there are really deep connections between the climate justice world and the fight for 15 and fairness, and I wanted to sketch a couple of them with you today in the spirit of making these connections and of growing the movement that is going to bring the change that we so desperately need. How many people here have read the Leap Manifesto recently? It's not a test. Okay, so fair enough. I'll give you a quick brief, so it's not like, what? Leap Manifesto? Who? What? What is this guy talking about? The Leap Manifesto was launched in 2015 during the last federal election. And it was a moment a little bit like this one in Ontario. It was a moment where the truly scary right was rearing its ugly head once again. And at the same time, we're being told by too many that the only alternative was the austerity liberals. You know, like we're getting emotionally manipulated to not go for the scary right-wing candidates, so instead we should bring in the people who have been bringing us austerity for generations. In that case, in 2015, we were trying to get rid of Harper, which was great, and that was a good thing that we did that. But there were a whole bunch of us who felt in that moment that in an election, we were just unsatisfied with the options being offered. We felt there was a lack of ambition, a lack of excitement around the proposals that all our politicians were offering us. So instead of so many people who are calling for just to do what's possible, let's just make the practical change that's possible in this political moment, a bunch of us got together and decided to call for what is actually needed. So this went back to a meeting we had in May of 2015, where we invited about 60 social movement leaders and organizers from all across this part of Turtle Island. We had indigenous leaders from the tar sands, we had housing activists and immigrant rights activists from downtown Toronto, migrant workers advocates were there, faith leaders, there were trade union people in the room. There was a whole span of environmentalists from like direct action folks to big green NGO folks. And we brought everyone together for a couple of days to talk about what was the potential for working together outside of our silos. And a bunch of different things came out of that meeting. That summer in 2015, there was a huge march in Toronto called the Jobs, Justice, Climate March. And I know some of you were there. Fight for 15 and Fairness brought this awesome banner, which you're gonna see again in a minute. And another thing that came out of that meeting was the Leap Manifesto. And the Leap Manifesto is very simply 15 political demands that would get Canada off fossil fuels in a hurry, in a way that systematically attacks economic inequality and structural racism and the other crises that we face in our society. It is a call for a Canada based on caring for the earth and one another. So I'll just read you one quick quote from the manifesto that sort of sums up and touches on where I think the climate justice movement broadly and the Leap specifically is really in sync with the fight for 15 and fairness. We could live in a country powered entirely by renewable energy, woven together by accessible public transit, in which the jobs and opportunities of this transition are designed to systematically eliminate racial and gender inequality. Caring for one another and caring for the planet could be the economy's fastest growing sectors. Many more people could have higher wage jobs with fewer work hours, leaving us ample time to enjoy our loved ones and flourish in our communities. So the Leap Manifesto and channeling these many, many movements that wrote it is a vision of a fight for a safe climate, grounded in the fight for decent work, for a decent life for all, for the vast wealth of our society to be benefiting the many and not the few. I mean, we live in an era of unprecedented wealth. There are 2 billionaires in Canada who control as much wealth as a third of all Canadians. We don't lack for wealth. A few years ago, the excess profit, just the cash on hand in corporate bank accounts, was enough to retire the entire national debt. Not the deficit, the debt. So there's no lack of money, but it's not being shared. We have a crisis, an existential crisis of what we're doing to our home, to our mother, to the planet, which requires a transformation of all of our systems, how we feed ourselves, how we get around, how people are housed, and what kind of work they do. Why wouldn't we make this massive transformation of our society in a way that benefits everybody? We have to do it that way. So, naturally, it goes back to the first principles that we have learned from our teachers who come from cultures that have taken care of this earth for hundreds of generations. And so the Leap Manifesto is grounded not just in the primacy of Indigenous rights, but in the Indigenous view of the world, of all of our fates intertwined, of the connections among us and our connections to all living things. So there's a bunch of different demands in the Leap, but the one that I want to focus on that really connects for me in this moment, particularly after that beautiful video where caregiving is so central to the low-wage work that should be high-wage work, to the low-value work that is the highest-value work in our society. This is part of the Leap that I think you guys will appreciate from the Fight for 15 and Fairness lens. When we think about like low-carbon jobs, you know, green jobs, and we need millions of them, we usually think, or we usually see in the mass media, pictures of guys in hard hats. It's always guys. Yeah. They're always in hard hats. And they're putting up windows. And that's great, and we need a lot of that. There's no question that we need a lot of that. But what about the existing low-carbon economy? What about people who already do low-carbon work? Caregiving is low-carbon work. Teaching, daycare, healthcare, caregivers are all low-carbon workers. The majority of the real economy, the things that hold society together, the actual connective tissue of our world, is caregiving, is the way we take care of each other, and those are all low-carbon jobs. We don't think of them that way, but we're here to say care work is climate work, and that's an important message for the inspired by this connection around care work and being low carbon work. And I think we need to go even further and see even more deeply into the Fight for 15 and Fairness and the communities that have driven the incredible power behind this campaign. So minimum wage workers who are serving other workers like a coffee and a muffin in the morning, let's say at Tim Hortons, those people aren't serving. They're taking care of us. They're taking care of each other. This is low-carbon work. Tim Hortons workers are low-carbon workers. They're green jobs. We have to recognize it as that, and we have to value it properly. So I assume this is why Fight for 15 and Fairness is launching a climate caucus. And how fantastic is that? Their very first climate caucus meeting is tomorrow, and they already have produced their first leaflet. Come on! This is organizing with organizers. I love it. I am going to read you the first words of the first climate caucus leaflet. for the fight for 15 and fairness, newly launched climate caucus, climate injustice and economic injustice. We're in the middle of a climate crisis which disproportionately impacts indigenous, racialized, and migrant communities. This is intertwined with an economic crisis that pays poverty wages to low carbon workers while providing no alternatives for high carbon workers. So this is it. You are already making the connections that I'm here to talk about, and I really appreciate my work being done for me by the Climate Caucus. So thank you, Climate Caucus. Our struggles are intertwined. We know that we face multiple crises: economic crisis, structural racism, the climate crisis. They are intertwined and feeding each other. So we need solutions that solve multiple problems at the same time. Big, transformative solutions. Not just the 15, the fairness. That's the big one, isn't it? Woo-hoo! We should have free tuition from cradle to grave. Yeah. Education is a right, it should be free for all. We need massive investment in public transit, public housing, 21st century public services that are free and universal, that serve the many and not the few. But the only way we're gonna do it is together, by taking this analysis of overlapping crises and advancing our vision of overlapping solutions and building the power to win it with overlapping movements. And that's why I'm so happy to be here with you today. Supporting indigenous leadership is in the national interest. Defending the water and the earth and the air and the land, that is in the national interest. So people all across the country are taking water from the BC coast to Liberal MP's offices today, right now, actually, an action started in the last half hour, to tell them that water is more important than profits. And I just want to say from the Leap to Fight for 15 and Fairness, thank you for what you do. We love it, we appreciate it so much. Have a great day. Woo!